fans hoping for win number one of this NFL season. The Minnesota Vikings have won the toss, elected to receive. Their defending to our right in white, and the Bears will be kicking off from the left. And we welcome those Minnesota Vikings fans and those in the region who have joined us for this telecast. Hope you enjoyed the earlier game, and welcome to Soldier Field. You haven't missed anything here as yet. David Palmer and Robert Tate of the deep end. You're looking at Jeff Jaeger. He'll be kicking it off, and Jaeger taking that duty over after the loss of the punter Todd Sauerbrunn in last week's game. He's gone for the season with a knee injury. Just as he unloaded a punt, he was hit, and he's gone for the year. He normally would have the kickoff duties, apart from being one of the brilliant punters in the NFL. That's a big loss to the Chicago Bears, and they've sent side Mike Horan to take over the punting duties today. Jaeger's kickoff comes down at the 2-yard line. Palmer, and a good open field tackle drops him at about the 18. That was Frankie Smith making the tackle. 17-yard return. Randall Cunningham will lead on the Minnesota Vikings offense, which is one of the most explosive in the entire National Football League. Stussy, an all-pro player, along with another one right next to him in McDaniel, leading the front. Robert Smith, the exciting and brilliant young running back. And Reed Carter, the wide receivers, with Andrew Glover, the tight end. And they start with three wide outs. No major surprise there. Randy Moss, the rookie from Marshall, the number one pick on the opening down of the game. And a big hole for Robert Smith, and then it closed quickly, but he still got three, close to four on it. Defensively for the Chicago Bears, they've got their hands full today, as you heard from Bill Moss describing that Vikings offense. Sean Lee, Mike Wells, Jim Flanagan, John Theory, the front four. The linebackers in the middle, Barry Minter, and they like the work of Rico McDonald, his nickname. He's been their toughest so far. Harris, Parrish, Marty Carter, and Tom Carter, the secondary for the Bears. They'll be in a lot of nickel today against the three-wide offense presented by the Vikings. This is Smith taking off one tackle. Gets another two, maybe three on the play. Andre Collins and Walt Harris on the tackle.
Well, the Minnesota Vikings, Tim, came out, and what they're doing is they're taxing the Bears' defense. You have three wide receivers. We saw the three wide receiver set from the start. From the first play, the second play, three wide receivers. You spread them out. You spread that defense out. You get them concerned about the receiver. Then you hit Robert Smith. First two carries was Robert Smith right into the heart of the Bears' defense.
Now with third and four, they have Leroy Horde and the speedy David Palmer. Palmer into the pass route. The pass is complete out the right side to Randy Moss for a first down at the 32-yard line of the Vikings.
And Moss was the guy that was open. You know what? Randall Cunningham's going to have the decisions to make of who they're going to have to get the ball to. Now, in the slot was Carter. Carter was in the slot, and he gets doubled. Watch the double. Then outside, there's a double. Then there's outside, there's Moss. He's one-on-one with Harris, and it's to find the open guy. It's tough on a secondary because you can't find three cover cornerbacks.
Randy Moss with 15 catches coming into the game over the first three games, averaging nearly 15 yards each time that he catches the ball. And that one off the mark from Cunningham, intended for Jake Reed on the right sideline.
Well, you can see really right now, early on in this game, Bill, what they're trying to do is they're going to play a little man-to-man. They want to see if they can challenge these wide receivers playing man-to-man. Now, I think that's a big mistake because they're going to try to go up top early.
Terry Cousin has come in defensively to make it a nickel defense here on second down. Denny Green, got to love the offense that he's been getting from his Minnesota team and hoping the defense can join them at that same caliber. Dave Wanstead just wants to win. He knows a lot of pressure on his defense today. Cunningham, little screen for Robert Smith. Smith has running room, and down the sideline, Robert Smith is going to score. Touchdown. Robert Smith takes the screen pass for the opening score on the opening series for Minnesota. For Robert Smith, the longest reception of his pro career. Gary Anderson for the point after. and the explosive Vikings jump into a quick 7-0 lead with a 67-yard score.
Ronnie, you talked about the man-to-man coverage. They came out with the three wides, a man-to-man. They take the receivers downfield, and they're all covered up, and then they run the screen underneath. Here comes the pressure up the seam. They get everybody sucked inside here defensively, then watch outside. There's the defenders because they're playing man-to-man.
And what happens when you have that happen, now you can't come off. And when you got a guy like Robert Smith, a track guy that can run 4-4, he can take it all the way, and they can give high five right there.
Brian Billick, the offensive coordinator, watch the cover. See the coverage? Now watch what happens with the receivers. Watch what the receivers do. They run their routes. Now look at them. They're all covered up. Then they stop, and now they block. They turn back in, and they start blocking. The defense is inside. There it is. Look at the blocking downfield. That's one thing the receivers do for the Minnesota Vikings. On the run plays, they are going to block you. They take pride in that as much as they do in getting the home run ball.
And you can see right here, watch Jake Reed. He's going to work back. He's going to make his block right there. You'll see Chris Carter make a block right there. When you talk to these guys, yeah, they complain about who's getting the most balls, but they also say who's going to make the most blocks. And you can see right there, that's why this team is explosive.
Now there's the offensive coordinator, Brian Billick, talking to Randall Cunningham. They have stunned the Bears and the Soldier Field crowd with a quick strike, 67 yards, 81 yards over five plays, and Robert Smith going the distance.
That's what happens. You get caught up in those three wide receivers. You have to watch out for the other aspects of the Minnesota Vikings.
Glenn Milburn and Robert Chanty are back to receive the kickoff for the Chicago Bears, and we've just been told that Mark McGwire has hit his second home run. That's 70 on the season for McGwire. And a little miscue there. The ball buried at the 15-yard line by Chancey. And so the Bears will start from their 15-yard line. Eric Kramer will lead on the Bears. 3-4 is the starter against the Vikings. Jimmy Herndon getting the start for the injured Andy Heck. He's out with a foot injury. Perry, Wegman, Valerio, and across the front. Kramer having to start from his own 16-yard line on the short kickoff. It was just fumbled a bit and then buried by Chancey. And the pass on first down intended for the big tight end Alonzo Mays, just a little bit high for the big guy, the rookie from Oklahoma State.
That's one guy they want to get into the mix of their offense. And they came out and attacked him. You know, you look at Minnesota, there's a power-built team. They're built for power, they're offensively and defensively. And getting behind in score is tough on them right now.
John Randall, you'll see him everywhere across that front today. Dwayne Rudd, brilliant-looking young linebacker. Of course, Ed McDaniel, you heard Bill Maas talk about him. Orlando Thomas rounding back into form after his injury that bothered him most of last season. Second and 10, three wide receivers are in. Chris Penn joining Conway and Ingram. And that is complete for a Bear first down to Bobby Ingram. Over the 30-yard line, near the 32, a 17-yard gain.
You talk about them, those guys, the Bears offensively, they've got to get the ball downfield, Ronnie.
Yeah, they got to get the ball downfield, and you got to be smart. Kramer right there was able to read the defense, saw something there where Ingram could be open, was able to get the ball to him, but Kramer is the key there. If they're going to throw the ball, he's got to be smart with it.
Ryan Wetnight makes it a double tight end formation. He's number 89, joining Mays. And the give is to Bennett, Edgar Bennett, number 32, veteran out of Florida State, acquired from the Green Bay Packers as a free agent.
Bennett's a guy in there that he's in there actually still as the starter in front of Enos because the experience. He knows what to do. He's flawless in his protection when you're playing pass, and he also knows the pickups on the blitzes.
Ty Halleck, the fullback, the lead back in the I formation here on second and 9. Blitz showing. They go to Bennett. Bennett picks his way past one tackler, then he's driven back after a gain of maybe 3 on the play. Dwayne Rudd, the linebacker, number 57. Second-year man from Alabama leading the push on him.
And we're talking with Dave Wonsett, though, he said as soon as Enos gets that big game, as soon as he has that huge game of about 125, 130 yards, he will be my starter. They really feel that they have their backs of the future in the two young guys in Enos and fullback Robert Chancy. We'll be seeing both of them a little bit later on.
Chris Penn comes in to make it three wides again. Robert Chancy in the lineup right now. Kramer downfield. He's got Chris Penn. Penn with two spin moves nearly broke away, but he turned into the traffic. Nonetheless, a good play for Penn and a first down in Vikings territory. 19-yard gain. And now for an update, let's find out from James Brown about Mark McGwire.
Tim, simply amazing. Give a listen to Joe Buck.
First and third, two out.
The equivalent of a Bill Moss or Ronnie Lott type of hit. Mark McGwire, 10th multi-home run game of the season. Back to them, Bill and Ronnie.
How about that? 70 for Mark McGwire on the final day of the regular season. This is complete to Engram. Engram has another bare first down. Inside the 35 of the Vikings.
Ronnie, you and I talked about how do you beat for the Bears. You know, they run the ball. They try to chew up the clock. They're 0-3. What do they need to do? They need to get the ball downfield. You talked about it in the opening. Now they're coming out. They're actually, this is the most they've thrown in the beginning of a game since they've started the season.
Yeah, and I think Matt Kavanaugh saw some weaknesses in that secondary. Matt Kavanaugh, the offensive coordinator for the Bears, said, look, if we can get the ball to our guys early, we have a chance of winning this game. And so far, they've done that.
First down, Chicago. Three wides again. Eric Kramer going to the air effectively on the Bears opening series. Downfield, he's got a man. That is Engram. Touchdown. Bobby Engram, and Eric Kramer answers the challenge. A 33-yard score to Bobby Engram, replying to that opening explosive run by Robert Smith with a screen pass for a score.
Different Bears offense than we've seen in the opening 3 weeks.
Jager for the point after. Mike Horan, the new punter, is the holder. And Jager has tied it up at 7 here in the opening quarter. 9:04 to play in the first period at Soldier Field.
Well, if you're going to pass the ball against the Vikings, you have to have the protection up front. John Randall's not getting where normal push he gets. Nice pocket. Kramer steps up. And they beat the 4-deep zone.
Yeah, and when you beat the 4-deep zone, Griffin, the secondary guy right there, he has to carry that guy. Orlando Thomas, you got to get over there. Those two guys were late on that play.
He wasn't the only guy open, too. What I want you to watch also the tight end in the middle here. He's wide open. Kramer had his choice. Both of them were touchdowns.
There's Engram taking it to the house, as the players say, and a great start for the Chicago Bears in their first offensive series, bouncing right back from that explosive blow leveled at them by Cunningham and Robert Smith that opened the scoring for Minnesota in their first series.
You know, there's a feeling out process in the beginning of games, and you watch the game tapes and you watch the way the Bears have played the first 3 weeks, and your defensive coordinator, you're thinking, well, I've got to sit back and see what they're going to do. You know, this is a group that runs the ball. They want to pound it at you. I'm going to have to get the strong safety up. And now you come out and play them. They're 0-3, and it's a different team. They're throwing the ball.
Yeah, Bill, and not only are they throwing the ball, but Kramer made some great decisions there. Throughout that drive, he was patient. He was able to find the right guy. And if, as long as you are able to do that with this offense, you can score points.
And the kickoff from Jager taken at the one-yard line by David Palmer. Palmer runs into a pile up there at the 22-yard line for the Bears. Special team effort, doing a good job holding it to a 20-yard run back, and it's Jim Schwantz who made the initial contact.
Well, the Bears cover team is one that started off. Watch Frankie Smith, 29 and 59, Schwantz. They stay in their lanes, and they get down there, and then they get rid of the blockers, and they close on the ball. Watch how they close around. That's perfect kickoff coverage. Staying in your lanes, get down there, and then just close in, like corral the ball carrier.
Schwantz and Frankie Smith, among others, they acquired just to play special teams and be backups, but to improve that area for the Bears, and they've been effective through the first three games plus now.
Hey,
Robert Smith on first down, gets a couple. Marty Carter on the hit.
Marty Carter is going to be an active guy today. He has a lot of responsibility as the strong safety when you're playing the three wides and then you get to run the ball. Watch him. Watch him sneak up to the line of scrimmage when he realizes it.
What I like about this guy, he knows how to find the ball, and he's a good tackler. And that's what they talked about. They have to tackle Robert Smith well this week.
Bears attending to Ty Halleck, their fullback, on the sideline. We haven't got an injury report, but he was being down and attended to. That's complete out the right side to Chris Carter, the veteran, number 80. Picked up of five, maybe six on the play.
Cousins, Terry Cousins, number 21, is only 5'9". Watch him inside here, right in here. He's on Chris Carter. That's a matchup we're going to see all day. And when you're playing them and you're going to get the underneath stuff, what you have to do is you have to tackle as soon as they catch the ball and don't give them any yards after the catch. And that's exactly what Cousin did there.
Cousin the nickelback, now joined by Marlon Forbes, number 46 in the secondary for the Bears, on this passing down, third and six. Cunningham, a lot of time and off target intended for the tight end Glover. Incomplete, and the Bears defense holds the Vikings this time, bringing up a punt. 7-7 the score, 7:35 remaining in the first quarter.
Jimmy Flanagan got some pressure there late, but for the most part, Randall had time in the pocket. He was looking for the tight end Glover, and it was just a poorly thrown ball.
Yeah, it was a poorly thrown ball, but that's what you want. You want to keep Randall in that pocket. You want to let him pad his feet. You want him to hold on to the football and then have to make a decision. It was tight coverage there, Bill. He had to throw it right at the target and missed it.
And Milburn back. Mitch Berger, former Bear, the punter for the Vikings. That one goes out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. It's a good field position here for the Chicago Bears. Mark McGuire, in case you missed it, a pair of homers today, bringing him to 70 for the season. And, of course, playoff action just ahead here on Fox. Tuesday night, game one of the American League Division Series. The Texas Rangers take their Western Division crown into New York to take on the Yankees. David Wells scheduled to pitch for the Eastern champions. It all begins live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, right here on Fox. That's Tuesday. What a dramatic finishing day in baseball. The battle, of course, the Giants, the Cubs, the Mets battling for their wild card positions. 38-yard punt. First down for the Bears at their own 31-yard line. Kramer throwing on first down. That's complete to Chancy, the fullback. Robert Chancy forced out by Corey Fuller. Gain of close to seven, maybe eight on the play.
That's what Chancy likes that. He likes that out of the backfield. That's just what he wants to get. Now watch Kramer, though. He takes a late hit here from Alexander. And Alexander, there's no flag on it. I saw the referee run over there and talk to Alexander, but that's a late hit in my book.
So he got a lecture instead of a penalty?
What am I saying? It's a late hit in my book. That's a clean hit. I'm a defensive lineman.
Second and three. Before they get the play underway, and it may have been that Tony Williams of the Vikings a little too eager.
Yeah, that's who it was, number 94 defensive tackle.
They want to get him more in today, the 23-year-old from Memphis, fifth pick a year ago. Listening to their coaching staff, they think he's a comer who can add even more to the Randall ball bunch.
Well, he's exactly like John Randall. He's the same
before
size.
The snap, false start by the offense, number 38. 5-yard penalty, it's still second down.
Well, they got Chancy in motion in the backfield.
So the penalty against the Bears. And we're here in Chicago, Illinois, under a brilliant sunny skies. Very, very warm for late September, 90 degrees and high humidity. We welcome those joining us along the way from other games. 7-7 the score here. The Vikings got off first with a screen pass 67 yards to Robert Smith in their opening series. The Bears came right back 33 yards to Bobby Engram for the score. And that is Edgar Bennett, and he has a Bear first down.
That's the power Bears. And that's what they'd like to do. They like to attack the perimeter. What they try to do is they get that scoop to the outside and try to bunch everything up inside. Turn the defensive end, turn the outside linebacker, collapse him, and don't let the scrape come from the inside out, and it gives you the seam.
Ball at the 48-yard line of the Chicago Bears. Engram and Penn, the wide receivers. Kramer hangs in there and Got it to Engram, and he couldn't hold on. Tight, good coverage from Corey Fuller, number 27.
Yeah, Corey Fuller is the quarterback for the Minnesota Vikings. He's playing a lot of man-to-man early so far, and they're going to go at him a lot today. But what he has to do right there, he was able to fight through the play, but what he has to do today, he's going to have to give some different disguises, some different alignments, because right now they know when he's in zone, they know when he's in man, and they're going right at him.
They know if he's been bad or good.
Three wide receivers in for the Bears now, including Fabian Bones, number 82, making his first appearance. The pass out for Engram. Again, he couldn't hold on. Fuller again put the rip on him.
Engram jumped up, and he's mad because there was a push while the ball was in the air.
Yeah, it was a push, but I think he grabbed his hand, Bill, right there at the end of the play, and he got away with one. The referee in the back cannot see, but look at that hand. He's holding on to the back, to the right arm. You can't do that. You got to give the guy a chance to at least catch the ball with two hands.
He got away with
one. Got away with one.
So that'll make it third down from the Bear 48.
Once that was hot, he was running down the sideline.
Last couple of plays, they haven't had Conway on the field. Bones out there again with Engram and Penn. Kramer going deep down the left sideline, and that is incomplete. Intended for Fabian Bones. Jimmy Hitchcock had the coverage. And so the Bears will have to punt. 5:54 still to go here in the first quarter. Mike Horan making his first punt as a Chicago Bear. The veteran picked up after a tryout this week when they lost Todd Sauerbrunn to injury last week. Gone for the season. And they've got two punt returners, Randy Moss joining David Palmer. Horan gets a good kick away. Lands in the end zone. 52 yards for Mike Horan on his first punt as a Bear. And the Vikes will start from the 20-yard line when we return to Soldier Field. That is seven. That is Soldier Field. We have 5:42 to go here in the first quarter. And we mentioned earlier, a big loss to the Bears here, Bill, with Sauerbrunn gone for the season. And that led to really three changes. Sauerbrunn was the punter. Now Mike Horan comes in, and he got off a good one there, starting the Vikes from the 20-yard line. Cunningham trying to find an open man. Now he comes on Carter. That was a great effort by Carter, trying to somehow stay in bounds and make the catch, but a top target incomplete.
There's a flag down.
And a flag at the end of that play. Let's see what Ed Hockey there, referee number 85, has to say. Little discussion here.
Well, they dropped the hat on the sideline, so that meant Carter was out of bounds before they threw the ball. Now, he didn't catch it, so it can't be.
Well, he tried to keep his feet in bounds and somehow make a catch, and we've seen Carter do that. He's remarkable, but this time he was falling back. It would have been quite a circus catch, but it was incomplete. Let's see what they rule.
There was no foul on the play, although the player was blocked out of bounds. He never reestablished himself, therefore there was no illegal touch. Second down.
Okay, Ed Hockley, after the Judiciary Committee met, came up with the ruling.
Well, what that means is when you're out of bounds, he was pushed out of bounds by the defender, and then you have to come back in and reestablish yourself. And it's an illegal touch if you're the first person to touch the ball after you go out of bounds. But since he was pushed out, there's no flag.
So it's second and 10. Smith. He gets about five. Robert Smith and John Theory, the defensive end, ranging back to get him.
Bill, they talked to us this week about getting pressure. It looks like right now the Chicago defensive line, they're getting pressure, but they're not holding the back lane.
They're getting sealed off at times. They're getting depth across the line of scrimmage. The defensive linemen are getting in the backfield, but they're giving up gaps to the backside.
Marlon Forbes into the secondary. Mark Thomas in as a pass rusher here on third down and five. It's a long five Cunningham needs. Cunningham 3 of 6 at this point. Cunningham, and that is caught out of the backfield. David Palmer for a first down, Minnesota.
And they bring in the nickel back right there defensively. They brought in a nickel package because of the wide receiver set. And they split David Palmer out wide here, and they stack him behind Reed. And Reed's the clear. Then he comes underneath. That's John Theory.
Yeah.
Really a pass-rushing defensive end that's dropped back in coverage. They only rushed three up front. They dropped Theory to the back, and they made the connection to Palmer. Mismatch.
First down, Vikings. Ball spotted at the 39-yard line in Minnesota. We're tied at 7, 4:12 to go. First quarter. Robert Smith. Tripped up by Marty Carter after a gain of about 5, maybe 6 on the play. They're going to spot it right at the 45-yard line. It'll be 2nd and 4.
For the Bears, they have to find a way to control the line of scrimmage. You talk to the Bears and you talk to their defense coordinator, Bob Slowick. They said, we have got to have gap control. We have to take Robert Smith out of the equation. If you shut them down and make the Minnesota Vikings one-dimensional, then you've got a chance because you know what you're battling. But if they can run and pass on you, it could be a long afternoon.
2nd and 4, Smith again, and Smith has room. First down, and only had one man to beat, or he would have been down the sideline. Tony Parrish forced him out at
a down block here, and then Christie comes out and leads the way. Christie's a little bit undersized at 280. He's better when he's running. Watch him lead the way when he gets up on the backers in the strong safety. That's how they're using Jeff Christie a lot more at center now. They block down the big guards on the nose man and get him out in space and put him up on a linebacker.
First down, Vikings at the Bear 40-yard line. Play action, Cunningham just got it away. Good catch by Carter, and he's taken out of bounds at the 37-yard line. A flag on the play. Theory led the charge on Cunningham. There's a holding signal apparently against the Bears.
Defensive holding, that's going to be 10 yards and automatic first down. Must have been away from the play on the backside here, Ronnie.
I think it's down here with the cornerback holding the wide receiver, and that's going to happen today.
Holding, defense number 23 before the pass is thrown. 5-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Marty Carter, number 23.
Yeah, Marty Carter's right there. He's lined up over the tight end. Right here, he says, uh-oh, I got to grab something. Why? Because he saw the bootleg. Now, he's supporting the run. He's been up in the run. That's what you do to a strong safety, to kind of slow him down. So maybe he doesn't get too involved in the run by running a bootleg and running the tight end across field.
We talked about Marty Carter and the adjustments he has to make with coming up and playing the 8-man run and dropping back and getting in this pass route.
First down from the Bear 35. They bring Randy Moss an end around, if you will. A reverse coming off his wide receiver spot. And the Bears covered it fairly well, but of course, another thing for the Bears to be thinking about through the rest of this game. Turns into about a 3-yard gain and a Bear player down on the play.
Brian Billick, in his plan of offensive game planning, always has about 5 or 6 plays where he's going to take a shot and do something. And those shots usually come, Ronnie, when they cross the 50-yard line.
So we have a timeout with a score tied at 7. 2:47 to go in the first.
What was
Tom Carter being taken to the dressing room here in the first quarter? He was injured on the preceding play. Bill, what happened here?
Chris Carter, we talked about the blocking of the wide receivers early on and how they get involved. Chris Carter tried to come up and help out. Boy, that's a big blow because they needed every corner they have on that roster to play the Minnesota Vikings.
We've got Ricky Bell in as the nickelback. Cousin will move into Tom Carter's regular corner spot. This is 2nd and 6. And Smith is stuffed by the Bear front, led by the linebacker Barry Minter.
Well, led by Minter, but it was Marty Carter up there as the 8th man again, and that's what they're going to have to need to do.
Yeah, Marty Carter right there was able to sit back, and he's trying to give a too deep look, but now he's able to walk up in the line of scrimmage. They can't account for him, and he does an excellent job of stepping up in the hole. But what he was doing there, he was patient. He was patient with Robert Smith, and he was able to make the tackle. And that's what you have to do against a great back. Be patient, stay right there and focused on him.
Terry Cousin and Tom Carter's spot on the corner, and the Bears had 2 offensive players go down already in this first quarter. Ty Halleck and Curtis Conway. That pass intended for Palmer, a little too high from Cunningham. Cousin had the coverage. And now for an NFL update, let's go to James Brown.
Dan Reeves knew this play would work against San Francisco. Take a look at how well it was executed. Chris Chandler dropping back. What does he do? Throws it. It's tipped twice. Terrence Mathers right there to haul it in. 49 yards to pay dirt. That narrows the gap. 14-7. San Fran on top of the Falcons in the first. Take it back to Tim, Bill, and Ronnie.
Well, that's some ad-libbing. That's ad-libbing. That's ad-libbing like the pregame crew.
The Bears force the Vikings punt. Beautifully popped down the poach to the 2-yard line from Mitch Berger. And Robert Tate down there to cover. So the Bears starting deep in the hole.
By Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. And by Volkswagen, on the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Back at Soldier Field, tied at 70. You're looking at Dave Wannstedt, the Bears head coach, who has seen three starters go down. Ty Halleck is back out there after suffering a stinger, the fullback, and he's joined by Curtis Enos in the backfield. Curtis Conway has a strained groin, and he hasn't been back. On first down, they go deep down the left sideline for Penn. He can't quite hold on. Jimmy Hitchcock on the coverage.
Well, he had it in his hands, too. He had it in his hands, a little bit underthrown. He had to stop and wait on it. Tough adjustment when you're running full speed and you think you're going to get the long ball and you're going to have to get it dropped into your hands and you have to stop, turn around. Heck of an adjustment, but they're taking their shots.
Yeah, they're taking their shots because they were able to see that it was an 8-man front. They knew that they had man-to-man on the outside, and right there, Chris Penn had Hitchcock.
Bones in now, make it three wide receivers. Edgar Bennett comes in for Curtis Enos in this formation, second and 10. They're at their 1-yard line after that perfect punt from Berger. Kramer gets good time. That's a Halleck, the fullback. Halleck running hard, gets out to the 15-yard line, and a Bear first down. Rudd and Thomas combine on the tackle after a 13-yard pickup.
If it's an area, Bill, that you want to attack with this Vikings football team, you want to attack the secondary. And so far, Kramer's done an excellent job of checking off and hitting all the underneath receivers.
Kramer 6 of 11 passing with a first down now at the 15-yard line of Chicago. Zenith breaks one tackle and butts his way up there close to the 25. Orlando Thomas and Dixon Edwards finally pull him down, and the rookie.
I'll tell you, I enjoyed talking with him yesterday, and you really get a feel for what he's all about. A smart kid and a determined kid. And watch the way he runs. He likes to deliver the blow. Watch him bring his arms and hands right up into the, see how he tries to explode up into the tacklers? He's a guy that will always be falling forward and gaining yards as he goes down.
Penn State rookie at 242 pounds. Second and one. Zenas again. A good ankle tackle on him from behind by McDaniel. Ed McDaniel pulls him down. There'll be a loss on the play.
And that's what Eddie McDaniel does so well. He seeps through all the trash right there in the middle. Now, Eddie McDaniel is a guy that's been playing the weak side linebacker position in the past. Now he's playing the middle, and he's really helped out the defense against the run.
Well, that's the end of the first quarter with the score tied at 7. Fox NFL Sunday continues after these words and a message from your local Fox station. Feel a hot, muggy afternoon under bright, sunny skies in Chicago. The Sailors getting the last of the sailing season this late September. Very unusual weather for Chicago.
Well, I know it's only the start of the second quarter, but I never would have thought that right now Chicago has more passing yards than the Minnesota Vikings.
Well, they came out throwing, and they've been without Curtis Conway. Right now, they've got four receivers spread across in early movement. See whether they were drawn or not. Week 4 of this NFL season, the unbeaten Vikings coming in here and being tested so far by the winless Bears.
For the snap, encroachment, defense, number 96.
Well, Jerry Ball, that's the nose tackle. And he's kind of hard to miss. And also, when he gets that big body going forward, it's tough to stop.
raise his hands like, oh.
Well, he knew he was wrong, but he couldn't stop his body. Yeah, that's 360 pounds. He couldn't stop it, so it's like, I surrender. He just,
hey, it's me.
And hit behind the line, Ed McDaniel once more.
Yeah, I was talking about it. That's what he does so well, seeping through the trash. And did you see how fast he came through the line?
Now, he was out.
Major knee injury for most of last year. Watch 58. Right here.
And the reason that works, though, is because of the guy we were just talking about that surrendered. But on that play, he was able to take up two guys, Bill.
Jerry Ball. That's what he's in there for. That's what Jerry Ball's in there for, to allow McDaniel and Dwayne Rudd to flow to the ball.
Second and 13 for the Vikes. Blitz from the Bears. From the Vikings, pardon me, and Kramer connects to Alonzo Mays. Mays gets it out to the 35-yard line.
Yeah, Mays is a guy that I think has a lot of potential. It's been taking us some time to really grasp his offense, but they need a lot of play out of this guy. He was a guy that everybody talked about that could have been a first-rounder. He has boodles of talent, and now if they can get him involved with this pass offense, he could be a threat that could take something off those two wide receivers, Bill.
Boodles of talent. I shall not soon forget that. He's just a little rough, but he will be something special when they file off the boodles of the edges.
On third down, Kramer, and it's in and out of the hands of Chris Penn as Jimmy Hitchcock came in. May even have got a hand on that, but he sure broke up the play.
Yeah, he sure did. Actually, it looked like it went in and out of the hands of Hitchcock.
Yeah, I mean, that's probably the great throw right there. The decision that he made on this particular play, Kramer, the quarterback, he should have just held on to that and tried to eat that and maybe go to his second and third receiver.
Well, a man standing there with that knee brace on is Todd Sauerbrunn, the injured punter, gone for the year, and Horan just got it away. Might even been partially blocked. It goes out of bounds at the 45-yard line of Minnesota. There was a big rush on Mike Horan. And so great field position for the Vikings after a 20-yard punt.
Take a look at Mike Horan's punt. Not touched by anybody. Look how short it is. And now you're giving the Vikings a short field. With Sauerbrunn, look, they're at the 45. With Sauerbrunn, they'd be getting it back at about the 20.
First down. Cunningham gives it to Leroy Horde, and he is straightened up behind the line of scrimmage. It was Sean Lee wrapping him up. Horan, as you can see, two punts averaging 26. He nailed the first one into the end zone, brought it out to the 20, of course, but that was a killer there.
Well, the yards lost. I mean, you don't want to give the Minnesota Vikings any more yards. They're capable of getting enough by themselves.
Second down and 8. Fallgrass Mattis comes in to give Flanagan some relief here defensively.
Oh, he got him on the hard count, which Randall was always good at. I remember when he was in Philly. He had that, you know, you talk to Randall Cunningham, he's got that passive voice. He'll come in and he'll talk to you like this, Tim. And he'll get behind center and he'll bark out some signals. He got everybody going.
He got the Bears going.
Yeah, it's funny because, as we all know, Randall has that other side to him that's a little actor. You know, that acting side that he has that really comes out when he's playing the game of football.
Well, now this discussion will lead us to believe that maybe they're considering that they drew the Bears over. Because this isn't cut and dried here. We've got the committee working.
Neutral zone infraction. Defense number 93. Came into the neutral zone, causing the offensive lineman to move. 5-yard penalty, it's still second down.
Fallgrass Mattis, backup defensive tackle. 3-year man out of Notre Dame, gets the call.
Well, you take a listen to the hard count. And this is what's tricky. There's some quarterbacks in this league that are very good at it.
Watch the run, run!
That first one, that first hard count is what drew Grass Mattis and others into that neutral zone.
Only Fox Sports can get that, baby. and it sounds like an Emmy right there, right?
Second and 3 from the 48-yard line, now in Bear territory, still tied at 7. 12:31 to go here, first half. It's Robert Smith, and Smith finds a nice opening and has the first down. The 42-yard line of Chicago.
And I talked about the Minnesota Vikings, and I talked about all the things they're capable of doing with all the personnel grouping. They bring this guy in, this guy, three wide receivers, two wide receivers. DeLong that time was in the backfield in motion. I want you to watch DeLong. Here he is here. Now watch him seep across here. Now watch him. It's almost like an H-back. He waits, he waits. Then he seeks out the linebacker, and he gets up, and he, two blocks he gets there. And that gets the push and the first down for Robert Smith.
High formation now. Play action to the backfield. Goes to Charles Evans, the fullback, for a gain of about five. And that is Tony Parrish making the tackle for Chicago.
We talked about Evans getting the catch right there, and we also talked about Robert Smith, and Randall is being patient. I think Brian Billick, the offensive coordinator, is being patient. He's taking what's given to him underneath. The Bears aren't going to give you the deep stuff. They are very well aware of the wide receivers of the Minnesota Vikings. They're going to force Minnesota to methodically move downfield.
This is Robert Smith off the left tackle. Got past the first hitter, but was buried then after a gain of about four. And it was Mike Wells, the tackle, with Andre Collins, the linebacker.
You know, then they get to run the ball again, too. And Chicago's playing this smart. You got a tie game here, and, you know, it's tough to, for an offense in this day and age, to move the ball downfield, to sustain drives, to go 10 plays or more, and then get a touchdown out of it.
Third down and three. The crowd getting into it here. And Cunningham with a sneak for the first down to the 30-yard line. Now let's find out what's going on with another Chicago team from JB.
San Francisco and Chicago are tied for the wild card in the National League. Colorado rookie first baseman Todd Helton could care less. A three-run shot. That brings Rockies within one of the Giants. That in the top of the sixth. And get back to Tim, Bill, and Ronnie.
All right, well, we know the Mets are gone, so now it's a two-team battle, and the Chicago Cubs in the thick of it. First down for the Vikings here at the Bears 30. Pressure on Cunningham, goes deep to the end zone, and it's knocked away. Coverage was there from Walt Harris.
Well, you got Dave Wannstedt right now. He is on fire, because if you look at this, you will see that they got offensive linemen moving around, and they're not set there. And to me, Randall Cunningham kept the play going, kept the play alive. Some of the guys stopped on the Chicago Bears defense.
Well, did you see where Parrish was playing? Parrish, the free safety, was playing by the goalpost. He was all the way back. He was so deep. They're not going to allow anything behind him. They're going to keep everything in front of them.
And the intended receiver was Randy Moss, but the coverage was there. Second and 10. And they give it to Smith.
Hey, it's over!
Smith barrels for about five, gets inside the 25 of Chicago.
Now, I know playing football, you want to be involved, but when you're out of the frame, either you're trying to hide yourself, or are you going to make sure that you keep everything in front of you, Bill?
That's the whole idea. They've got to keep everything in front of them. You know, talk to the safety, talk to Marty Carter. He said he and Parrish, the key word this week was get and stay deep.
Third and five. Horton Palmer in the backfield now. Palmer sets up on the wing. Cunningham is sacked. That is Mark Thomas.
That's his third sack of the year.
And that was a nice move, Bill. That was a nice move.
I want you to watch Thomas. Thomas is down here working on Corey Stringer. He takes the inside on him, and Horde doesn't get a chip. Leroy Horde actually runs right by him. He takes the inside on Corey Stringer, and Horde doesn't get a piece of him.
So they'll try the long field goal from 51. Gary Anderson, and he has it. Gary Anderson, who had five field goals last week, connects here from 51 yards out, and the Vikings on top 10-7.
I believe I can call.
Officially 50 yards by Gary Anderson. Open a 10-7 lead here with 8:38 to go in the first half. Tim Ryan, Ronnie Lott, and Bill Maas at Soldier Field. Bears did a good job defensively. Came up with a sack to push them back But Gary Anderson, one of the best in the business, the all-time field goal kicker in NFL history, connects again.
Well, I go back and I go back to the Horan punt, and the Bears defense played good. And if you get that extra 24 yards on that punt, and they don't get that field goal, they never ever even attempt it.
That's right, Bill. And I think what you see there, especially from Gary Anderson, they talked about him just being a dome kicker right there. That was an excellent kick by him on this grass.
Basking in the sun. A kicker's life. Tough, huh?
Yeah, 17 years of it.
And they've got Mitch Berger handling the kickoff this time for the Vikings, their punter. Remember, we mentioned that Curtis Conway has not returned because of a sprained groin. They said he would get back into the game. We'll be watching, of course, to see if he comes in. Boy, there's some wind blowing here in Soldier Field. That one went all the way to the back line. And so the Bears will start from their 20-yard line when we return. Looking at the voluble John Randall, getting himself pumped up here to have some conversation and hopefully get in on Eric Kramer. First down from the 20-yard line. Bears trailing 10-7 with 8:32 to go here in the first half. Jason Fisk and Dwayne Clemens also in the front now for Minnesota. Halleck in motion behind the ball. Play action fake to Enos. And they've got Bobby Engram. Engram breaks a tackle and gets to the 45-yard line. Corey Fuller pulled him down.
Ingram stepping up and becoming the big play guy now that Curtis Conway's on the sidelines. And no matter who it is, it's got to be somebody, because the Bears have to open up their offense, and they've done it more so this game than they've done in their prior three games. I mean, they've come to the conclusion to say, hey, we got these guys, we have to use them.
Bears beginning this drive at the 20. That's three of four drives they've been at their 20 or even deeper, that one at the one-yard line. Kramer gets time, and it's dropped by Chris Penn. Ball was right there for him. It looked like he jumped when he didn't have to and came down without the ball.
And right there, you have so much momentum going. Eric Kramer's been throwing the ball really well. They've identified that they're in an eight-man front. They see that they're getting man-to-man coverage on the outside, Bill. And right there, you got to keep those chains moving. You talked about production. They got to get it out of pin as well.
And it's always been one thing or the other so far for the Bears. It's plays like that, they can bring them right back down.
Second and 10, Chicago. Give it to the rookie Enos, and he is buried there. Nowhere to go out the left side. Good push from the defense of the Vikings. Dwayne Rudd, Orlando Thomas combined to get him.
Here's John Randall. His motor's always going, even when it's not supposed to be going. And he gets the push, and you see the push outside as well by Clemens, and they can't turn the corner. They string that thing all the way out to the sidelines. And with the offensive line tied up, then your backers get to make the play, and Rudd was flowing free. Nobody touched Rudd.
Third down and 10. They got Randall out on the end. They've used him all over. Kramer, he's got a man open. That's Engram again. Inside the 25. Torian Gray, the nickelback, pulled him down. Bobby Engram really filling in well, a 33-yarder.
Nice route by Engram. He turned Griffith around.
Yeah, he turned him around. And what he does, he works outside, then back in over the middle of the field. Kramer, though, is throwing the ball extremely well, and you gotta like the fact that when you see Kramer now, he's kept this Vikings defense off balance throwing the football today.
Kramer on first down. Again, good protection. He's got 10 touchdowns. Chris Penn.
He found the weakness, Bill.
Chris Penn, the five-year man from Tulsa. Remember, they're going without Curtis Conway, still out with a groin pull from the first quarter. 23-yard touchdown. And Eric Kramer, who has been bothered with a muscle strain or spasm in the upper part of his back, and he talked to us about that and said that the guy is Now he's feeling better, and obviously he's throwing well into the wind here in this quarter. Jaeger, point after, 14-10. The Bears take the lead.
Chris Penn on the touchdown catch. And what he did there was the moves, Ronnie. The moves he put on Hitchcock. I want you to watch right here. Watch, he's down, down, and then back into the end zone. And he gets Hitchcock turning as well. See the moves?
Yeah, and the safety, Orlando Thomas, saw the guy flash in front of him, Ingram. And that's where the safety had the bite on the middle, and it gave that hole open there, Bill.
Jaeger's kickoff comes down at the 6-yard line, taken by David Palmer. Palmer with a nice move. Palmer over the 40-yard line. Finally stopped by Terry Cousin. He only had one more Bear to beat. 36-yard return.
Now you talked about, you touched on it, Tim. You talked about Kramer and that injury, and we'll talk about it as soon as we get back. When they said, we got a pass, Ronnie. You talked about it at the top of the show, and those numbers are indicative of it.
Yeah, we talked about hitting some home runs. And so far, they hit a couple out of the park.
So they have a first down, Vikings, here at Soldier Field with 6 minutes exactly left. And that one batted down, almost out of the hands of Cunningham. Mark Thomas got a hand up on it. And that was close to being a fumble, but he had the forward motion, and Thomas just swatted it away.
Thomas got the rush in there, and he got his hand up and batted. But watch the effort he gives. Then he goes after the football, and then he feels that it was caught. Here's Thomas on the outside right here. Watch him come, 95. Gets his hand up, bats it down. Then he thinks it's a fumble, and then he goes after it, and then he realizes Palmer has it, and he tackles him.
He did all that was required, but it's just second and 10. Robert Smith gets to the 45-yard line, a gain of 4. Mike Wells and Marty Carter coming up to help him.
One of the areas they needed inside here was Wells, 97. That's what, see what, he didn't do anything. You know, you sit there and say, well, what was that? You know, he sat in there and he tied up those guys. And he doesn't let the wall move him. And that's one area that really the Bears needed in the offseason. And they got Wells from Detroit.
You saw Jim Flanagan there in the center of your screen asking for a Bear timeout. He was upset about something, that they weren't quite ready for the next play. So he took a timeout on behalf of his team. And we'll be right back after our timeout.
Wait, the NFL, the United Way, and you, the power of teamwork.
Tim Ryan with Ronnie Lott, Bill Maas, 5:18 to go in the half here at Soldier Field. 10-7, the Bears leading the unbeaten Minnesota Vikings, who have -1 yard passing in the second quarter. Randall Cunningham had that 67-yard screen pass to Smith. After that, only 31 yards on his ensuing 4 completions. Third down here, they're 3 of 6 in this department, and now they are 3 of 7. The sack from Barry Minter.
And you say you got to gamble. You say you're 0-3, and that's what you do right there. You leave the middle of the field wide open. Nobody will be in the middle of the field. You say that you're going to take these 3 amigos, those 3 great wide receivers, and man up your guys and bring everybody and sell the house, Bill.
They rushed 8, right? They only had 3 guys covered. You know the trend has been we're rushing 3 and dropping 8? They brought 8.
Lynn Milburn back for the punt. Comes down at the 19-yard line. He's got some running room. And gets out to the 35-yard line. Glenn Milburn, good field position for the Bears. 46-yard punt, a 16-yard return. And the Bears playing that last defensive series without either of their starting defensive backs, both out with injury.
Well, you talked about gambling. I mean, it's actually selling out. All these people from the 50 in rush this way. Only 3 drop. And if they have any attempt at all to pick it up, you got a chance for a big play, but they get to him. They get to Randall.
And Dave Wannstedt says a lot by that play right there. Our team, we're going to do whatever we can to win.
And they have the lead. 14-10, Chicago lead. This is Enos out to the 40-yard line. Gain of 6 for the rookie.
That's one of their favorite plays, the counter play. That's their power run game. They start everybody off and wonder. Everybody goes this way. Even the back takes a step this way, and the backside guard comes around this way and kicks out. Watch the running back take a step. You take a step, now watch it come back out the back door. Now you get everybody bunched up defensively in there. That's a heck of a play for them. They do it out of a variety of formations.
Ryan Wetnight comes in to be the tight end. 3 wide receivers. Fabian Bones, number 82, joining the regulars. A big hole up the middle for Edgar Bennett and a first down Bears.
Watch Edgar Bennett use his eyes and use his vision. Look at these guys right here. Todd Perry turns out, and then look at the scene in there. Edgar Bennett starts in one direction, and he sees the cutback where the hole is. Herndon and Perry walled their guys off to the outside. You know, that's what Minnesota Vikings defensive front jumps upfield. They just walled them off.
Bears in the I formation on first down. They're at their own 48-yard line. Staying on the ground, there's running room for Enos. Enos blows through one tackler and has a first down, Chicago, at the 38-yard line.
They are mixing it up against the Vikings defense. It started early in the game, but they are in flow right now. Look at James Herndon, the offensive tackle, filling in for Andy Heck. Watch him get up on the linebacker.
And that's what they're doing, Bill. They're taking away the speed of the Minnesota linebackers. The linebackers using those counter plays, it makes that linebacker hesitant. Now they're able to run off the tackle, and they're doing some good things mixing it up, Bill.
First down, and Kramer looks like he's changing it up here. Wide to the right is Ingram. He's been the pass receiving star. And the delay of game, they couldn't get the audible call to everybody ready for the change made by the quarterback, so they have to take time out.
Still first down.
2:43 on the clock. First half. And the delay penalty, I don't mean the timeout, I mean they're taking the penalty for too much time used. So it is first and 15. Change in defensive personnel for the Vikings now with a first and 15, and Kramer again looking downfield here. Play action pass, and it is caught. Nice catch by Halleck, and Halleck picks up close to 8 down near the 32 of Minnesota.
Yeah, that was a nice catch by Halleck. The ball was actually thrown behind him.
But you got a coach going on right here. You got a coach by this guy right here you're seeing on your screen right there, Eric Kramer. He's done an excellent job of identifying what's happening on the other side of the ball. There he saw 3 guys in the back. He was able to get to the flat with his fullback, and that's what you got to do. You got to have a coach, and he's being a coach there.
We've reached the 2-minute warning. And I know McGuire got 2. What about the home run hitters we were expecting here from the Vikes?
Yeah, so far, those home run hitters have been shut out. But they have a chance of coming back and doing some damage, Bill.
Well, they do, and the Bears, of course, have to worry about their second half collapses. Right now, they're in charge. And that's Curtis Enos. Eric Kramer's been the passing star, Bill.
Well, nice cutback run there by Enos. And Ronnie touched on it, on getting the Minnesota linebackers flowing one direction and coming back on them.
Kramer is 6 of his last 8 for 114 yards and a touchdown.
You know, this series has been all runs. The series before on the scoring was all passes.
And they have a first down at the 25-yard line. Again, Kramer changing it up. There's the fade for Penn, yeah, overthrown, a flag down.
Jimmy Hitchcock got that hand on him, grabbed him.
Went into the cookie jar and got caught.
Penn was helping the official make the call.
He was reaching in the pocket for the flag.
That'd be something if a guy carried his own flag and threw it.
He gets the call.
Kind of like street basketball, you know, when you call your own fouls.
Pass interference by the defense, number 37, automatic first down.
They'll have first down at the 11.
And right here, Penn does an excellent job of selling it, now getting back, and Hitchcock had to go into the cookie jar and grab him. And if I'm a defensive back in that spot, take it. Take the penalty, grab him, because that would have been a touchdown.
Now the Bears really want to score here. They want a touchdown. Four times they're in the red zone at Tampa Bay and failed to come up with a major score. This is Enos, and he just blasts his way inside the five-yard line.
Billy talked about getting small. He talked about getting small at 245 pounds.
And talked about punishing tacklers. And this kid runs hard. Look at him attack the hole, and then when it's about to close, you see him lower his boom. He lowers the shoulder pads and helmet together at one time. That's the boom. He brings it down on you, and he keeps the feet churning. I like the way he runs.
I like it too, Bill. I like the way he runs, and I like how he gets small right there at the end.
Edgar Bennett comes in now on second down, just inside the five-yard line. Kramer, a little bit of a roll. He's got a man open. Touchdown. That's Engram. Bobby Engram.
They are mixing it up so well offensively right now. Eric Kramer is on fire. You mentioned, Tim, we talked to Eric Kramer about the neck. He said, I asked him, are you concerned about getting hit and all the quarterbacks going down? He says, I was. I had this ball in the back of my neck. I was concerned. I got an MRI, and they said it's fine.
Point after from Jager is good. 21-10 Bear lead with 28 seconds remaining. First half.
Ronnie, he talked about it. He says, I got that MRI, and they said it was fine, and I knew right then that I have the confidence now.
And the confidence is right here, being able to pick up Engram right there on the flat. What you like about this play, he sees that he's got some time, he's patient, he knows that he's going to get a little pick route there where the receiver goes inside, Engram goes to the outside.
Engram had 9 catches coming into the game, 6 today.
Watch here. First of all, watch the run fake, and everybody's froze in the middle here. Everybody's stuffed inside thinking it's going to come outside, and they do a waggle, and nobody's underneath. Chris Penn cleared the way into the end zone, and Bobby Engram underneath.
4-yard score. The Bears go 66 yards in 7 plays, take 4:19 off the clock, and have a 21-10 lead as we approach halftime. Jeff Jager will be kicking off.
Completely different Bears team than the first 3 weeks.
Well, they got off well in those first 3 games, but they just collapsed in the second half. And the Vikings, an explosive team, of course, they feel that they can come back. But you got to like the way the Bears have played on both sides of the ball so far in this game. That squib kick.
That's Chicago's ball.
Came right up one of the Vikings, and the Bears got possession. Now, you'd love to know whether it was intended to work exactly the way it did, but it was perfect.
Well, you're talking about a kicker that hasn't kicked off, hasn't been kicking off. I think that would be tough if that was intended. I think the squib kick was intended. They had no idea it was going to hit the Minnesota Viking defender.
It came right off Chris Walsh and right back to the Bears. Watch this.
They had no idea. No, that
and
wasn't
Chris
planned.
Chris Walsh tried to catch it. He tried to catch the ball. You got to let that ball go through. You can't try to catch that ball. He tried to catch it, and it bounced right off his chest, Bill.
I think it caught him off guard. I think that was just a reflex reaction trying to grab it because that thing came right at him. He thought it was going up top.
And the Bears have the ball at their 45 with 25 seconds left. It was Frankie Smith who recovered it, one of the new players on the special teams. And they get Kramer this time back at the 32-yard line, and it was John Randall. By Randall. Well, remember, coming up on the Visa Halftime Report, JB and Terry will have scores and highlights from around the league, and our Fox Sports ticker will have up-to-the-second stats, all coming up on the Visa Halftime Report.
Well, that doesn't happen very often to the Chicago Bears. That's only the second sack this year.
Well, the fans here who haven't had much to cheer about in recent years, and this year, winless in their first 3, are on their feet, sending the Bears to the locker room at the end of the first half to score 21-10 Chicago. We'll be back after this
Can they hold on, or will they blow it? They lead the Vikings by 11. Steve Young having a big first half. First pass to Jerry Rice. Second pass to Jerry Rice. A little deep end route. Excellent throw. Excellent catch. Jerry Rice 66 yards later. It's touchdown. 49ers up by 7. 168 career TD passes for Young. Make it 169 as he rolls left. Back of the end zone. There he is. J.J. Stokes. 49ers all over the Falcons. 30-7. Chris Chandler, a lot of dropped passes in this game.
All right, New York Giants all over the Chargers. Giants' worst-rated offense in the league, leading 21-3 over the Chargers. Turnover problem for Ryan Leaf continues.
Seahawks 7, Steelers looking good. Cordell Stewart out of the pocket, moving him around a lot. Packers 37-30 over the Panthers. 5 touchdown passes on the day for Brett Favre, Packer of the visiting of the Colts. That is. There's the score. Cardinals, Jake the Snake Plumber, 2017 over the Rams. And there it is. Broncos looking awfully good, 38-16 over JV's Redskins.
Super Bowl bound Raiders.
As Holly Long would say, where's my money? 13-12 over the Cowboys at home.
Eagles, oh, they lost it.
They look good. They tease us, but it was the Chiefs, 24-21.
And the last 7 contests between these two teams decided by 8 points or less. The Jaguars win it today, 27-22. Mets out of the wild card chase. They lost today to the Braves by the score of 7-2. As we move along the baseball scoreboard, Cubs and Astros tied at 3. This one is in extra innings here in the bottom of the 10th. Minutes to go. Vinny Castillo. Boy, look at this home run shot here. That helped Colorado to go ahead of San Francisco. The score now 8-7. San Francisco, of course, needs to win in order to tie, if the Cubs do win, in order to tie them and force a one-game playoff. That will be tomorrow in Chicago. Anything you want to add, sir?
I'll tell you what, Ryan Leaf, a young kid struggling, most young quarterbacks will. You can't give up on it.
Some will go to local news. Others will come back and see Mark McGwire's explosive ending to a historic season.
Kickoff return by Glenn Milburn. It took a punt back for a score, and a good one for him. That was last week, of course. Milburn's exciting touchdown off a punt return. He brings this out to the 30-yard line. 32-yard return for Milburn.
And take a look at the halftime stats numbers. And the thing that jumps out at you right off the bat is right here. 197 yards to the 82 passing yards of the Vikings. And that really has been the story.
Now, how much of an advantage for the Bears to have the ball here starting the second half? And psychologically, it's got to be a real good jolt to start them with their 21-10 lead.
Well, it'll be a jolt if they can do better than that play right there. Now, if they come out in the second half and are the second half Bears that we've seen the last 3 weeks, then it's going to be a problem. If they come out and drive the field and get another score, that'll be a new turnaround and a starting point for Chicago.
Well, if you look at this team, what they did, Bill, they were able to start out mixing it up. Now they come out and they say, well, you know what, we're going to run it. I hope that they continue Matt Kavanaugh, the offensive coordinator for the Bears, keep them mixed up, keep it mixing up, keep mixing it up.
Don't get conservative.
Loss of about a half a yard on that first play by Bennett. Slot formation right, Kramer, and he threads that and the ball comes loose. It's incomplete. Penn did not have full possession of the ball, and so it's an incomplete pass. That'll bring up third down.
And one thing the Chicago Bears have always done a good job of when they play the Vikings, and the Vikings have different ways of getting to the quarterback. You know, John Randall, they move him around, and then Foltz Fazio will bring his blitzes and stunts. But Chicago, whether it's up in Minnesota or here at Soldier Field, their offensive line does a good job of containing that rush of the Vikings.
Third down play. They have slot formation to the left this time. Kramer gets some time. Now he swings it out for Bennett. Bennett with a spin move away from one man. He'll be short of the first down, but he picked up about 7 near the 37-yard line of Chicago. That'll bring on the punter, Mike Horan. Mike Horan, in case you joined us along the way, of course, the Bears' outstanding punter, Todd Sauerbrunn, injured last week, gone for the year with a knee injury. Mike Horan won a tryout contest this week here in Chicago. And he gets a hold of this one. David Palmer and Randy Moss both back. And this is David Palmer, always dangerous. Only the punter to beat. Now getting some help, and he's down inside the 35-yard line.
I don't know if that was help or not. Torian Gray was up there trying to help, but actually he got in the path of Palmer.
51-yard punt, a good punt for Horan, but a 53-yard return.
Right, that can take the wind right out of your sails. You know, Chicago's always waiting for something bad to go wrong. This can change the momentum. Watch David Palmer bring it upfield. Now watch number 23, Torian Gray, right here. He tries to get in front of him to get in a block, but actually he slows him down, Ronnie.
First down at the 34-yard line. One setback, Cunningham a short drop, and that's complete out the right side to Jake Reed, his first catch.
Complete to Jake Reed, wrapped up by Ricky Bell.
Gain of about 5 on that for Jake Reed. And while we talk about wide receivers, official word that Conway will not return for the Bears. He left with a groin pull early in the game, and he is not going to be back.
That's the first catch they've gotten to Reed this game.
Yep. Second and 5, Minnesota. Robert Smith, he's got room off tackle. Turns it upfield and gets inside the 20. Tony Parrish steered him out. 11-yard pickup for Robert Smith.
You can get that sense, and the fans are getting that sense.
It's quiet.
And you're starting to smell it, but I hope that they rally here. This is where you got to play great defense. This is where you got to be able to make a play. And the thing that I'm seeing right now, Bill, it looks like Minnesota now is changing up their game plan. They're mixing it up.
First down.
Look at this formation.
Everybody stacked up there on the left wing, and now they go to Smith behind all that blocking. But a good job defensively. That was Wells, number 97, putting the stop on Robert Smith.
Wells actually looked pretty athletic there. Big Wells, 97. Watch him in the middle here. Look, first of all, watch everybody get the block up top. You're trying to create that seam, thinking that, well, your 300-pound nose tackle isn't going to make the plays, and Wells does. They didn't account for you, Mike. They didn't account for you, but you accounted for the play.
Loss of about a half yard. Second down. Cunningham intended for Randy Moss, a little off target. Walt Harris is back in action. He left with a cut finger in the second quarter.
Walt Harris on that play was very physical, and he's not a real physical guy, but watch him disrupt the pattern.
Here, you got to finish the play. You got to run through there. When a defensive back gets in your way, keep running, because then the referee will say it's on you, pass interference.
You can see in that shot that his left hand is taped to account for his cut finger. So he's playing with a handicap here, but back in action. Third down, into the end zone, touchdown! Minnesota, the tight end Glover. So the Vikings come right back after that big punt return, a 19-yard touchdown. Puts the Vikes right back in it.
And before the game, I'm sitting there, I run up to Glover. I said, why are you standing next to Ramon Cunningham? He said, hey, he's the guy. He's the guy that can get the ball to me. That's why I wanted to hang around him. And right there, they read the coverage. They had the tight end right in the middle, Bill.
Point after is good. Gary Anderson makes it a 4-point game. Glover with the touchdown, Minnesota.
All right, Captain.
There's the man who brought the Vikings back to within 4.
And the guy that brought him here to this team was Chris Carter, Ronnie.
Yeah, Chris Carter gave him a call and said, hey, big fella, we need you. We got some explosive guys on the outside, but we need you on the inside.
Berger's kickoff. Comes down a yard deep. Then Milburn trying to get wide. Good job by the Vikings to close him off at the 17-yard line. Ramis McDonald wouldn't let him up the line.
I want you to take a look at this touchdown and watch what the Vikings do here. Watch the safety here, Marty Carter. He's going to cheat over to this side where the two receivers are, and your tight end's going to run right down the seam underneath him. And it's a natural thing.
it's like taking candy from a baby when you send that tight end up the middle. And as a safety, that's the toughest thing on a safety, because now you got to favor the outside guys with all those weapons, but you have a tough time folding back in and making the play, Bill.
So Chicago, first down from their 17-yard line, leading by four. Enos nowhere to go. Stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. Jerry Ball was there. And right now, let's get a baseball update from James Brown.
You saw Vinny Castilla put the Rockies up 8-7 in the bottom of the seventh. Well, guess what? Top of the eighth, Jeff Kent answers back. Solo shot to left field. Only second baseman, except Roger Hornsby, to hit 120 RBIs in back-to-back seasons. Cubs and Astros all tied at three. It's all tied at eight between San Francisco and Colorado. Back to you guys.
Oh, wow. Thanks, James. I mean, isn't that something? Both games tied. I mean, this is something else.
We'll keep you up to date on all of the action the rest of the day. Edgar Bennett this time. Only the Mets out of it. Now it's the Cubs or the Giants. And they may be facing each other in a playoff.
You got an injured Viking laying on the ground. Dwayne Rudd getting up slow.
Limping a bit, but not likely to come off. That tough young man, very impressive.
Well, he's a tackler. I mean, he's the guy, the stack backer. He stacks behind that big defensive line where they're getting the push, and nobody really touches him. And he's free to the ball to make the tackle.
Third down and seven. Showing blitz. It's picked up. Kramer still with time. He's got his man. A nice catch by Chris Penn.
Boy, that was a heck of a catch.
First down, Chicago. 20-yard pickup to the 40-yard line.
I want you to take a look at Eric Kramer. Watch him in the pocket. He has a blitz on. It's in his face. Torian Gray's going to just miss a swat right here. Look, he strips the ball. Kramer steps up with bodies flying all around him right in the heat of things and delivers a perfectly thrown ball to Penn.
First down at the 40. Enos to the corner. What a collision there. It was Thomas coming up.
Well, I can tell you right now, it's some wood going on here, baby. That was some wood right there. And the two guys, look at the safety up top, right? Look at the safety up top and see where they're going to meet right here. Oh!
A gain of three. Second and seven. It's a 43.
That was definitely a collision. Now in fact, Thomas is now being attended to. There you see him down on his knees.
Look on the sidelines. Enos is on the sidelines, and Thomas is on his knees.
Thomas, you know, he walked back from that play, but obviously he was shaken up. That was just a real meeting of more than the minds.
Yeah, and I've been in this situation, as you all know.
Yes, we do.
And I've been in the other situation where I'm 42, and I'm sitting there trying to get up, and I'm saying, how am I going to make it to the other side, Bill?
Well, he gave it his best impression of your number there, that's for sure. That, he was letting it all hang out there, Orlando Thomas. Torian Gray will come on to give Thomas a break on this play, at least. You have a feeling this tough man will be back out there, the 214-pounder in his fourth year.
He's pointing to his head. See, he said, I don't want the water in my mouth. Pour it on my head, because that's what's hurting.
Second and seven. This is Bennett. Nice piece of running by Bennett. Close to the first down. It'll leave third and about a yard.
I like the way Edgar Bennett runs certain plays. You know, he's really good on the screen play. And on the draw, when he gets up inside the middle, he's not actually a power guy, but he has enough power to fall forward and push forward. He's not really a slash guy, but he's got the skills when he gets around bodies to make people miss.
He reminds me a lot of Roger Craig, being able to be shifty in the hole, being able to be patient and let the things develop for him.
Third and a yard. Ryan Wetnight, the tight end, set way outside, comes back in, and it is first down, Chicago.
You know, you make that statement, Ronnie, and I look at the way he takes the handoff there and slashed right up through there, and I saw Roger Craig.
At the 47-yard line of Minnesota, Dave Wonstedt, 1-8 in his last nine starts in NFC Central action. Of course, all the fans know how important the games are in your own division. So this is just such a key game. They get off to an 0-3 start, losing to Tampa Bay last week after leading 15-0. For Minnesota, kind of in cruise control for the first three games and being sorely tested here by the winless Bears. Kramer, and he's got Chris Penn again. Penn's been having a field day now in the second half after Ingram. Now they're calling it incomplete.
No, don't take that away. Don't take it away.
So Chris Penn has one taken away from him after he had the first down yardage. See whether he didn't have full control, evidently.
There's a play action.
Looks like when he hit the ground, the ball came out, and there's Kramer taking a shot from behind. And it's ruled incomplete, leaving second and 10.
Well, his knee got down, but I guess they're questioning if he actually had enough control of the football when his knee was down.
Bennett, good running room for Bennett. He'll be close to the first down. We welcome those of you who have been watching the Cubs baseball game right now. Your Bears are up on top of the Vikings 21-17, 7:07 to go in the third.
And actually, the Bears have been very impressive today. They came out of the blocks, and they've mixed it up well offensively. They opened the game throwing the ball, a quick score early on, and then they've mixed it up with running and passing. It really kept Minnesota off balance.
Third and less than a yard. Play action. Kramer's got a man in the flat. Halleck. First down, Chicago, to the 23-yard line of Minnesota. And those of you who have just joined us, here's a quick look at the Bears' touchdowns today.
There's the Ingram right up the seam pattern, beating the safety. And you can see again, going to Penn in the middle of the field right there, and now going back to Ingram. Three wide receivers hitting home runs like Sammy Sosa.
Well, yeah, and it's the Bears wide receivers, not the vaunted Vikings wide receivers, who have been held totally in check. Mainly the Bears offense keeping them off the field. Enos, he batters his way for about four inside the 20-yard line.
We watched the Bears run the counter play to the left. Now they come back and watch. Now they come back and run the counter play to the right. They're attacking both sides, and Curtis Enos, he takes it. He likes to go north and south. Curtis Enos necessarily isn't going to bounce outside. He's going to go right up the gut.
Second down. No running room that time. Excellent defensive work. John Randall leading the charge and help right behind him. Now, you probably heard a roar from the crowd here. Let's find out from JB what's going on in baseball.
Look, lose this one because Ricardo Hidalgo hits a sacrifice fly. That brings in Carl Everett from third base. The Astros win it by the score of 4-3. But just 1 minute later, in Colorado, yes, Nathy Perez hit the home run. That knocks off San Francisco. One game playoff tomorrow in Chicago between the Cubs and the Giants.
How about that? Kramer, complete. That's Bones, Fabian Bones. Now remember, Curtis Conway, again, if you've just been joining us, Conway's been out of this game since early in the second period with a groin pull. In fact, I think it was late in the first quarter. And this Bear receiving core, including the likes of Fabian Bones, been doing the job for Kramer.
Kramer's been unbelievable. When he's been called upon to make something happen, he's been sensational. The Bears today are 6 of 9 on third downs, converting to first downs.
First down here from the 12-yard line.
Hey, it's
over. Halleck gets inside the 10 to about the 9-yard line. Last week, of course, the Bears were up 15-0 on Tampa Bay and then completely collapsed in the second half. But even in the first half, they struggled inside the red zone. So far, they're one for one there, and here they are again at the 10.
Well, the biggest thing is they're putting the ball in the end zone, whether anywhere on the field, because coming into this game, they only had two touchdowns offensively.
Second down. Eight to go for a first. They need to get to the two-yard line. Kramer into the end zone. Picked off. That's Fuller. Yard line by the center, Casey Wegman, or that could have been a touchdown the other way. Fuller just saw it all the way, it looked like, Ronnie.
Yeah, I think he saw it all the way, but all game, Kramer has been audibilizing. Here he looks at the defense, he recognizes it, and he says, well, I'm going to go to the outside. It looks like they're going to take Ingram away. Here, Corey Fuller steps in front, and if you look at Corey Fuller on his play, it tells you one thing. The Vikings got to figure a way to get back.
Right here. That's a 300-pound center, a 300-pound slug. Watch him get to the outside. And what he does here for Chicago is not only make the tackle. Watch the effort he gives making the tackle. He saves a touchdown. He saves 6 points by that effort right there.
Yeah, there was nobody else anywhere near Fuller. He would have had a free lane down the sideline. First down, Vikings. And there were whistles before the contact with Cunningham.
Because
flag at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, I believe Sean Lee was offsides, and the referees blew the play dead before it had a chance to continue.
Before the snap, ball start, offense, number 82. 5 yard penalty is still first down.
Glover, the tight end, the man flagged.
No, I was wrong on that then. There's a reason Sean Lee jumped offsides.
Yeah, well, stuff happens, you know.
Well, let's take a look. Here's Sean Lee. There's a little hunch right there. You see that little hunch? Glover just hunched his hips rolling forward. You see any flinch, you're coming off the ball.
First and 15. Short drop, Cunningham complete. Jake Reed, he's dropped immediately. Ricky Bell. Now remember, Ricky Bell forced to play out there because of the loss to injury of Tom Carter out with a collarbone. Walt Harris was out having his fingers taped together, but he returned. And the Bears have gone much of the way without Curtis Conway on offense, and Ty Halleck missed a series or two.
You know, Minnesota leads the league right now. I know it's early in the season, but they lead the league in turnovers.
Second down, seven. Screen pass, nearly knocked down. Speed. Smith for a first down to midfield. He went 67 yards for the opening score in this game, but there's a flag down back at the line of scrimmage.
No, it's holding on the defense.
14-yard gain, and they'll get some more.
The defensive holding's 10 yards automatic first down.
Yeah.
So with the yards, they don't tack that on to the it's either one or the other.
There's the choice. So the looks like 14 is the spot. Close to 15. And some more discussion here. Ed Hockley, the referee, playing the part of Henry Hyde there at the moment. The Judiciary Committee meets.
After the pass, holding, defense number 93. 5 yard penalty added to the end of the run. First down.
The Grassmanis, they call Grassmanis after the play. They're saying the Grassmanis is in here. And usually he'll.
I think he had the old takedown rule there, Bill. The center, was trying to get out there, and when he was trying to get out, I think he pulled him down after the play.
So it does turn out to be a tack on of five, and it'll be first down at the 45-yard line in Bear territory. Vikings trail by four, 2:37 to go in the third.
I don't know how the heck you can have that call. On a screenplay, if you're in the backfield, anybody that comes across you, you're allowed to tie him up.
And let's see what the Vikings can produce here. They haven't been able to get their big guns into the passing game as yet. This is Reed, and Reed has a first down. 11 yards to the veteran Jake Reed. Marty Carter on the tackle. The ball at the 35 of Chicago.
You remember, Ronnie, when you're on defense and they run the screen, they say if a back crosses your face or a tight end crosses your face or the screen, you tie him up. You wrap him up and don't let him get out. And you're allowed to do that because it's a backwards pass on the screen.
That's what I thought. I thought that as long as the ball's behind the line of scrimmage, you got to wrap him up and you got to be able to take away those blockers.
On first down, Cunningham going deep this time. And it's a touchdown to Chris Carter. Chris Carter for 35 yards and a touchdown. You knew they sometime, somehow, were going to make a long scoring touchdown to these great wideouts. And it's Chris Carter.
Well, Carter is matched up on Cousin, and he right away he has the size advantage. But it looked like he had a physical advantage there, too, because it sure looked like he pushed off on Cousin.
That's right. Chris Collinsworth talked about it last week in the pregame show, how Carter is able to use the body. Right there, you saw him use his body and his size to make the play, and that's what you got to defend up against when you're going up against a Carter. You got to play big. And right there, Cousins played small.
And the point after is good. Here it is again.
If you can see right here, now, look at the end of this play. Look at Carter get the separation. Collinsworth talked about that, and that's what he was able to do, and Randall takes his fingers to the sky.
Vikings take the lead. Chris Carter, he's got the football, and he's going to hang on to it, possibly because, believe it or not, this great veteran, it's his first touchdown ever at Chicago's Soldier Field. And I know there's a little girl traveling with him that are probably going to get to carry that ball home. His daughter Monterey came along on the road trip from Minneapolis. Deep kickoff through the end zone. Berger twice now has done that. The Bears will start from their 20 when we return. The Vikings on top by 3.
Proud sponsor of the NFL, an official airline of the Super Bowl. By GMC. See your local GMC dealer today. By Coors Light, Frost Brewed to tap the clean taste of the Rockies. And by Pizza Hut, home of the Edge, Sicilian Pizza, and more.
We're back here at Soldier Field with the Vikings leading 24-21.
Look at this right here. Chicago is dominating the time of possession and losing the game.
Well, they led at halftime in all three of the previous games this season, and then were beaten in the second half, and they must be thinking about that now as the Viking Jerry Ball steps Curtis Enos for a loss. 68 yards in 4 plays for the Vikings on the go-ahead score. Cunningham, 4-of-4 in that drive, passing to Chris Carter for the touchdown.
And Minnesota is trying to take over this game. They got the interception, they got the momentum offensively, then they score a touchdown. Now they come right back, Foch Fazio, and he brings the blitz. Dwayne Rudd came flying through there and met Ty Halleck in the backfield just as the handoff was occurring.
Second and 10. Enos this time, and he is dropped. Edwards making the first contact. Dixon Edwards, the linebacker, 59.
Dixon Edwards, John Randall, Rudd, they were all in there. Watch the speed of these guys. Here's Dixon Edwards all the way over here. Watch these linebackers flow while these guys are tied up. Look at them shoot through all the traffic and get to the running back. That's how the defense is designed. That's what you want them to do. You got your tacklers in there, use them. Tie up the guys up front and let your tacklers and athletic guys flow to the ball and make tackles.
Time winding down in the third. Third down and 12 for the Bears. That's Bennett. Bennett struggles for about 4. That'll bring up a punting situation, and the Boobirds quick to come out here at Soldier Field.
Well, because they've seen this before. They've seen the Bears fall apart in the second half, and they're feeling them coming unglued right now.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score of the Vikings 24, the Bears 21. Fox NFL Sunday continues after this. Oz and Ronnie Lott. Eric Kramer having himself an outstanding game. However, his one interception in the return set up the go-ahead score for the Vikings. Now the Bears having to punt. Taken by Randy Moss. Fair catch at the 35-yard line. A 42-yard punt for Mike Horan. We'll be right back.
FedEx to lots of different places, you get lots of different prices.
Send your packages in 2 days with UPS to lots of different places, you get lots of different prices.
Send your packages in 2 to 3 days with Priority Mail to lots of different places. You get the same product.
So, what's your priority? Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Part-time truck companies and four-wheel fashion statements. Maybe it's time the people who've devoted nearly a century to nothing but trucks gave you a better option. Introducing the GMC Envoy, a luxury SUV, certainly, but one built in the tradition of the great GMC trucks. The wannabes have had their fun, but playtime is over. The new Envoy by GMC.
Critics are calling that 70s show out of this world.
He has a net average of 23.5, and of course they knew they weren't going to have Todd Sauerbrunn numbers once he was gone.
Tim, I want to know what they're drinking at halftime in the Bears locker room, because in the third quarter they've come out in four games and not scored a point.
Well, and they are obviously can't help but be thinking that they've led at halftime in their three previous games, all of which they wound up losing. And at halftime here, it was 21-10 Chicago. Well, you saw Mark Thomas come flying over. Was he drawn? Will be the question, as usual. Let's see whether
before
or not.
Before the snap, encroachment, defense
well,
number 95.
No, that's not the case.
Penalty is still first
that's
down.
Not the case. This is just what happened on the other end. Now it happened and they didn't see it. Greg DeLong, 85, the tight end, moved, which drew the defensive end offside. I want you to watch right here. See the move? That's the same hunch that Glover gave.
And it brought Thomas over.
Yeah,
for
that's
sure.
The same hunch we saw before. At this time, the officials didn't see the hunch.
So it's first and five at the 40-yard line of Minnesota. They lead by three, starting the fourth period, and that knockdown came right back to Cunningham. And it was Sean Lee who got a hand up on it. Good job by that guy to get a hand on the ball.
Yeah, that reminds me of last year. I did a Vikings game, and Brad Johnson threw the ball, and it got batted right back to him. See how Randall gets it? He's just a little bit slower right there, and the pocket was Randall, because Brad Johnson last year came out of that and ran it in for a touchdown.
You know, that's actually a completion. Cunningham to Cunningham. Officially, that's what that is.
Yeah, I mean, you're not allowed to throw it after that, but you can advance it.
Right, or you could drop it and lose the ball, so it's really better just to have it be an incompletion at that point. All right, this is Robert Smith. There's a flag down upfield. He has the first down yardage to the 50. Such a graceful runner, deceptive speed, Robert Smith. But let's see what the flag's about.
Yeah, you can't come in and block low, and it looked like Moss came in and took out Marty Carter.
And they are calling that low block.
Those wide receivers are aggressive. They like to block. Chris Carter was telling us, and Cunningham was telling us, hey, you know, these guys aren't fighting so much about who wants the ball and who can I get it to. They're more, every time it's a run play, they're saying, hey, you got your man? Because I got mine.
Randy Moss, the rookie, a prodigy so far in the early part
first
of this
foul,
season.
Crackback, offense number 84. 15-yard penalty, repeat second down.
He showed in practice and in games he likes to block, but this one costly.
Yeah, and you can't do this. You can't go low. You got to stay up high. And Randy Moss, being a young guy, a rookie, you need to go look at the rule book. You need to go look at the rule book to say, stay up high, Randy Moss. That's something that he'll learn, and he won't do that again.
Well, again, the committee is meeting here on the spot of the ball. And they've just moved it upfield a yard to the 26-yard line.
That goes from the spot of the foul, is the 15 yards.
Second and 20. One setback, slot formation to the right.
Longer count by Cunningham. He has time, and he's got his man. And that is Carter, Chris Carter. A gain of about 10. Let's get an NFL update from James Brown.
Timmy, after a promising first two games, the struggles were abundant for Ryan Leaf. Here in the third quarter against the Giants, he throws his fourth pick of the day, picked off by Percy Ellsworth. He returns at 29 turnovers in the last two games for Leaf. He's been pulled. Wheelahan is in, 28-16. Giants, back to Tim, Bill, and Roddy.
Boy, I'm glad I'm not a beat reporter covering him this week.
Every camera will be at that press conference, though. He probably won't have one. Third and 11. Cunningham, Carter again, what a good catch. He had Harris, and Chris Carter comes up with a grab.
Well, they wanted to go with that same blitz early on, Bill. They wanted to try that medicine one more time. The medicine didn't work.
Hey, when you go to test the depth of the creek before you cross it, you use 1 foot. Because you could drown. And that's exactly what happens here. They send eight, they drop three, and there's the catch. It's a big gamble. It's a risk they're taking. They jumped in with 2 feet. The water went over their head.
Well, all the risks and gambles that were working effectively in the first half for the Bears. But the Vikings just steadying on, picking up their game here in the second. Robert Smith gets to the 40-yard line, a pickup of close to five.
And right there, Randall on that play, you got to give him some credit there, Bill, because he hung in there and he was able to see that the middle was open.
Well, that's what he's becoming. He's becoming more of a pocket passer. I mean, the old Randall used to dash out of there if the number one receiver was covered.
Right.
And he's taking his time. It's taken him a while to mature to that level, but it's been good for him, and it's also been good for the Vikings.
Well, he's on a hot streak right now. Eight of his last eight, including that long one he threw to himself off the hands of a Bear defender. That one is incomplete. Good coverage there. Jake Reed took a good smack. I believe it was Ricky Bell, and so that is an incomplete. And here are the Vikings scores. Robert Smith has a yarder on a screen pass.
What was that, about the third or fourth play of the game? They came out early, and then they came back again throwing the ball. This is to the second half, and then it's Carter deep.
So the Vikings with the lead, 24-21, 11:49. Big defensive play, the only turnover, and they nearly had it there. Great effort by Walt Harris.
Ronnie, the one thing I like, and we talked about, is the footwork of Walt Harris, the way he backpedals and plants. Watch the backpedal, then watch him drive on the ball.
And that's what you got to have, good feet. And as you see right through the ball.
When we return. Out to the tight end, Mays. Alonzo Mays got about seven on the play. Mays, the number four pick out of Oklahoma State, a big rookie they think is going to be a star.
Well, they try to get him the ball more and more in every week in the game plan. Find him ways, and it helps a couple things. First of all, him, it'll help. Secondly, it'll help the wide receivers more. Watch the play action. Everybody goes this way. Look at everyone going. It's got the defense going. Then it's Kramer out the back.
Bears have gone without Curtis Conway, their star wide receiver, since early in the game. Bobby Engram and Chris Penn picked it up for them. This is Curtis Enos, and his spin moves, has a first down, and a flag is thrown upfield. The Bears have started their 10 drives, five of the 10 drives from inside their own 20 and twice inside their own 10. And they get two good plays to get out. Let's see what happens here. And it is a holding call. So once again, they're backed up.
Looked like a good play
holding
there, Bill.
Offense number 81. Half the distance to the goal, repeat second down.
Yeah, it looked like a good play. and it seems to me that Ingram was doing everything that he could do to keep Griffin off of the on this play right here. Now he lets him go. I don't see the foul there. I don't see the foul.
Well, it backs him up to the 8-yard line, leaving second and 11. Kramer, 17 of 27 with one interception, but three touchdown passes, giving the Bears the early lead. They've done that 4 weeks in a row, but they trail by three. Kramer just got it away. He's got a man open. Just as he was hit, he could not quite get all of it as he took the shot from John Randall, and he couldn't quite get it to Wet Knight. It was wide open.
Really saved a big play there. John Randall, 93, watch him come from the top. He gets the hands up on Herndon and comes underneath him. Just gets the hands up and moves him. Watch the hands. Gets him, bang, right off him, and then comes underneath and just gets enough of a shot to disrupt the throw. And that would have been a big play. There was nobody in the middle of the field if he had caught that.
Third and 11, Bears. Herndon playing for the injured Andy Heck, out with a foot injury. The left tackle. From the end zone, he's got time. Kramer, and it's right out of the chest of Bobby Engram, who's had an outstanding game, but that one he could not bring in.
That's the Bears we saw the last 3 weeks. Third down, drop balls, Eric Kramer not sharp. That's the things that Wonstadt talked about. That ball was right on the money, and Engram just dropped it.
So Horan will be punting from his end zone. And it's once again going to be good field position. Randy Moss, fair catch signal in Bears territory at the 44-yard line after a 36-yard punt. And the Vikes have a lead. It was on a raft somewhere in a lake, and I fell off.
I don't even want to try to envision that.
Last one I did. Cunningham lets it fly deep. And it's caught. Touchdown! That is Randy Moss. Yards. The ball hung up a little bit, but the tall Randy Moss calmly awaited it and then just fell into the end zone. Randy Moss, 5 catches last week in the victory over Detroit. 54 touchdowns at Marshall, and what a career lies ahead in the NFL for him. Point after is good, and the Vikings now lead by 10.
We spoke with Randall Cunningham,
and you can see Randall right here. He says, I just got to throw it up to the big guy. I got to throw it up to him for one reason only, because I know that he'll go get it. And right there, he got it.
You are my son.
The Vikings have had it 4 times, and they've scored 3 touchdowns. And thus they lead 31-21. And as Yogi would say, deja vu all over again for the Chicago Bears. 10:06 to go to try and prevent what's happened to them 3 consecutive weeks, leading at halftime and then losing the ball game. Now they trail by 10. Glenn Milburn gets out to the 27-yard line, met there by Mays. 25-yard return.
Watch Moss up top here. Look at the cushion. Watch how fast he closes the cushion. It's closed right now, and he's panicking, and he's turned around, Walt Harris. And then when he gets down there and the shots they want to take, watch the vertical jump. Look how high he gets in the air. Nobody has a chance when he has a vertical like that.
And you talk to Denny Green, and Denny Green said, you know what he's got? He's got the same burst, the same closing that Jerry Rice has.
First down, Chicago. Slot formation to the right. Kramer. Out for Halleck. Halleck, the fullback, gets to the 30-yard line, a gain of 3.
I can tell you this much, Ronnie, that I remember when Jerry Rice was a rookie, and he wasn't to the level that Randy Moss is playing at right now as a rookie.
You're right. And I remember being out there trying to cover him and him closing that cushion like that in practice, But no, he's not at that level yet. Jerry Rice is a great receiver, and he will be one of the best who ever played. But this guy, Randy Moss, is on his way, Bill.
Kramer wanting to change it up. South Coach Fazio, the defensive coordinator for the Vikings here, wanting his defense to hold, not let the Bears back in this. Kramer just got it off, took the hit. This is Bennett. He has the first down. Robert Griffith on the safety blitz, but a big lick on Kramer.
Yeah, I mean, Eric Kramer just gets this ball off. Coach Fazio has him where he wants him. Watch him come right. They come inside. See him come in. Randall comes inside, brings Herndon down, and there's nobody back there to pick up Griffith.
First down for the Bears, nonetheless, at the 39-yard line. They need two scores. 8:50 to go. Bennett, just a couple this time, over the 40-yard line. Kramer, 19 of 31, 278 yards, three touchdown passes, having himself quite a game. But since that interception that led to the Minnesota touchdown, brought them back into the lead.
Tim, you know, the Chicago Bears had all the strategy they needed in the first half. They did everything they wanted to do. They mixed it up well. They played aggressive. They ran. They passed. Everybody was catching. Kramer was on. They just don't have the confidence now, because the same thing has happened to them over and over again. And now you have a penalty with Herndon jumping offsides.
For the snap, ball start, offense, number 74. 5-yard penalty is still second down.
And the guys talked about this, too. They said, you know, we don't know what it is. Something goes wrong, and everyone says, same old Bears. And they talked about the respect has been a factor they talked about here. Jimmy Flanagan told us, he said, hey, you know, with that game last week was nothing, but they didn't respect us. They didn't think that we could keep a lead.
And they started with so much poise and confidence in this game and showed it all the way through the first half. And bad things start to happen as the Vikings, with all of their talent, came to the throw and to the four in the third period. And that's complete right on the money to Bobby Engram, and a first down Bears into Vikings territory, and a flag down.
It's a flag, and it's going to be holding against the Bears.
20-yard gain is going to be wiped out at what appear.
Illegal hands to the face, offense number 74. 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
That's Herndon. Two in a row for Herndon.
Yeah, well, he's working on John Randall, and he's alone. Or actually, that's Clemens outside. And the hand just slides up right there.
Bill, you know, we had a chance to watch him on tape. You saw how they played. You look at what's happening right now. You take away a couple of these plays, this is a good football team. It's hard for me to sit here and watch this and say they're a bad team. They're just making some bad mistakes.
Great effort by Engram, but he couldn't quite get control before he went out of bounds, trying to one-hand that.
You know,
it was Torian Gray on the coverage.
You're exactly right, but the problem is this football team has a split personality. I mean, the good side of this football team is they come out and they look sharp, they look aggressive, they do things fundamentally well, they execute the offense. And then there's the other part of the personality, which is they lose confidence, they make mistakes, and they don't have any belief that they can win the game and finish it.
Bobby Engram, the star of the first half for the Bears in the receiving department, hasn't had a catch in the second half. Huge third down play here, and they need a lot of mileage. They go to Ryan Wetnight, the tight end, and he gets back about 12, but it's well short. At the 37-yard line, Chicago will have to punt. 7:05 and counting down. Dwayne Rudd made the tackle. Bears out there quickly for this punt play, trying to conserve clock time. Horan standing at his 22-yard line. And he gets a good kick this time. Palmer signals fair catch back at the 16-yard line of Minnesota. 47-yarder for Mike Horan. And we'll be back with the Vikings on the lead by 10.
K
change from the first half to the second half from the home run guys.
Well, just look at the numbers. That says it all. And you know, the thing about it is Chicago knew coming into the game. Now you have to think back and you have to say, well, look who's out. You know, Walt Harris got nicked. Tom Carter broke his collarbone. And it really puts a bind on the defensive secondary for Chicago. Minnesota has come out and exploited it.
First down, Vikings at their 20-yard line. The 15-yard line after Horan's punt. And this is Smith. Robert Smith dances his way for seven. Sean Lee ranges back to get him. Cunningham, 10 of 13 in this second half. You saw what his wide receivers have done for him. His contribution, getting the ball to them 10 of 13 times, three touchdowns, 163 yards overall for Cunningham, who will continue for another month with Brad Johnson on the sidelines with an injury. The starter for this powerful Vikings team at quarterback. Second and a long three, we'll call it four officially. Under the six-minute mark, Robert Smith, and he is stopped short of the first down. Theory, number 91, and Wells, the nose tackle on the hit.
And Chicago is just playing grinded out now. They have the big offensive line. They have Smith. It's run it out, chew up the clock, let the clock keep running. And, you know, you mentioned Randall Cunningham, and I said at the onset of the show, it's really up to him what he does. Yeah, you have all this powerful offensive weapons, but it's what Randall Cunningham... Randall Cunningham has done an outstanding job today of moving this team. He never got frustrated. He stayed. He plays within himself.
Third and two for the Vikings. This is huge for the Bears defensively. And Cunningham sneaks and has the first down. Twice today he's done that.
And the clock keeps moving.
And why not go to that play, Bill? He's the leading rusher in NFL history
sure
at the
is.
Quarterback spot.
Good job. Big man at 6'4", 215. Can you imagine? I remember I asked you guys the other day when I saw the numbers, 4,615 yards rushing for a quarterback. I mean, it's staggering. And there's just another couple for him.
Yeah, yeah, and he's done just about everything today. He's run the ball. He's thrown the ball. He even caught his own ball.
That's right. Pass receiver. You know, he's a punter, as we well know, a good one. And he's officially the backup punter for the Vikings. Robert Smith. Smith gets out to the 32-yard line.
And now Chicago's going to burn a timeout. Try to see if they can regroup and have a shot at getting the ball back. Otherwise, Minnesota's just going to let that thing grind and run.
4:25. Little look of discouragement and frustration on the face of Dave Wannstedt. Timeout on the field. A 10-point lead for Minnesota. Well, next week, another Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader. Barry Sanders will be coming right back here to Soldier Field. And we'll be here as well to watch him in action against the Bears, followed by the Eagles against the Denver Broncos and other regional action. Coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific on Fox. Check your local listings. See the game you'll be watching in your area on Fox NFL Sunday.
And you look at Chicago. You saw the second half. The second half. No points on the board, and really, they haven't done anything to establish. Now, after the kickoff run, remember they came out and you said, hey, you know, they got the football. Is this a good thing for them? I said, yeah. They came maintain the momentum they had going in at halftime. They moved the ball all the way down the field. They march it down, put together an excellent drive, and then a Corey Fuller interception, and that turned the whole game around.
Second down here. For the Vikings, Cunningham rolling, steps up away from the first rusher and connects. Good pass to Glover. Good job by Cunningham and a first down at the 45-yard line.
14-yard pickup by Glover. If you go back, I talked about the interception. It changed the whole momentum. They had a big drive going down there. They ate up about 8 minutes getting down the field from the opening kickoff, and then Fuller's play right here. And the next play, if you remember, was the bomb, the touchdown pass to Carter, and that just changed the whole momentum.
Now, Palmer helped him with a kickoff return to early in the third quarter that got them setting up their touchdown that drew it to 21-17. This is Leroy Horde, and Horde gets about five to midfield.
Oh, that's Horde. We've seen Robert Smith. Randall Cunningham has completed passes to 8 different receivers. And Ronnie, when you think of all the weapons that the Minnesota Vikings have, if I'm Randall Cunningham, I can only think to myself that to me, it would be like me in a buffet line, you know? There's all that food, and you can get whatever you want to eat, and you wait, how much? I want some of this, and I'll eat it, and until I'm tired of it, then I'll go back, and I'll get some of this. He's got to be the happiest guy in the world to have all those weapons.
Yeah, and I know how you eat in a buffet line. It's just like Randall. Randall said this earlier to me. He said, they got a new thing going on with the offense. Everybody's open on every play. Because Randall's going to throw it to any guy, no matter what the coverage is.
You try a little bit of this, you try a little bit of that, we'll get some Robert Smith, we'll get a little Glover, you know? And then the sweets, you get all the sweets. It's like the dessert tray is Randy Moss. When you sit back down there and just heave it, and he gets the vertical jump for a touchdown.
I like that souffle. I like that kind. That's a nice souffle, isn't it?
The Bears called a timeout here. It's going to leave 3rd and 5 at the end of that timeout. And we do have a chance to remind you that time permitting, we'll be taking our audience to the conclusion of the Giants-San Diego game. We've got 2:51 to play here, so kind of depending on how long it takes to finish up this one, some of you may get some bonus coverage and see the Giants in San Diego. But, you know, Dennis Green, he seemed to me to be confident yesterday, but at halftime, I wondered if he felt the same today as he did when he was talking to us last evening. Nonetheless, he knows his defense, maybe they've answered the question.
Well, yeah, they're confident, and I think they never feel like they're out of the game. And,
right.
And if you have all those weapons like we were talking about, and all those different food groups, you're happy. You know, there's what do you have to be unconfident about when you can score at any moment? And the Bears, Ronnie, this has got to just be brutal. Same thing 4 weeks in a row.
Yeah, it's the same thing 4 weeks in a row, but this guy right here, Denny Green, has done an excellent job keeping these guys focused and motivated. And despite all the problems, now they got it all straightened out. They're playing well. They know that they can come back and beat people now, Bill.
And even with a backup like this guy who played so well today, very much like the starter he was all those years in Philadelphia. Well, this time they get Cunningham, and they'll have to punt.
And one of the most underrated coaches I've felt for a long time, you know, because there's always something else surrounding the Minnesota Vikings, an outside-the-game story. But he's a great guy. The players love him. They stay here, and they want to play for him. He's gotten the team to the playoffs 6 times with 6 different starting quarterbacks. He has a relationship with the guys, and it starts. You know, it's interesting, Ronnie. He says he runs the scout team. He says, hey, I hire coaches to run my offense, hire coaches to run my defense. He runs the scout team. The scout team are the practice squad guys, the guys that never see uniforms. Some of them never even travel. They're just there during the week to give the offense and defense a look. And he goes out there and holds the cards up. And he talks to them and says, hey, you have to do this, you have to do that. And he gets to know them, gets to build a personal relationship with each of the guys, and teaches them and coaches them, each one of them individually in some little aspect. And that's where it all starts. So by the time they come up like a Brad Johnson, your starting quarterback, you've known him since he was a scout team player and you sent him over to NFL Europe.
Well, the best compliment that I could give Denny Green is when he was with the 49ers as the offensive coordinator, when Bill Walsh would have to leave for whatever reason, Denny Green would run the team. That says a lot about Denny Green. He's an excellent coach. Yes, he is underrated.
Berger punts it from the 40-yard line. Milburn signals fair catch at the 18 of the Chicago Bears. And we've been talking about the excitement in baseball here today and the playoff game right here at Wrigley tomorrow, but Tuesday night on Fox, game one of the American League Division Series when the Rangers take their Western Division crown into New York to take on the Eastern champs, the Yankees. Live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, right here on Fox.
Hey, man, and I can't wait for tomorrow.
Right here.
Dusty Baker, Giants. Yes, it's going to be exciting. Barry Bonds and the fellas. They got to get it going, man. I guess I live in San Francisco, man, so I'm pulling for my Giants.
I hope you don't plan on going to the game here because you won't find much company at Wrigley Field. First down, Bears. That's complete out to Ryan Wetnight, the tight end number 89, 6-year man out of Stanford. He's their most reliable receiver among the tight ends, but of course they think the man of the future is Alonzo Mays, the rookie from Oklahoma State. Drafted in the 4th round this year. Kramer, sideline, caught by Chris Penn. Good job, Chris Penn. First down. That gets him out to the 34-yard line, and you can see we showed you what Minnesota did first half to second half. Well, the reverse here.
The absolute reverse. Chicago went down because they came out in the second half and tried to control the game, control the clock, mash the football. And I think really some of Chicago's problems are that. They're torn whether to be the West Coast team, which they brought Matt Cavanaugh in for, or be a power run game.
Kramer going deep. And it is caught. That's Fabian Bones with the inbound. Yes. Fabian Bones, the second-year man from Western Illinois, a free agent back in 95.
I can tell you this much. If there is any discrepancy amongst whether we're going to throw the ball or run the ball, I think Matt Cavanaugh has built himself quite a case from today's game.
You got to say he built a case there because Eric Kramer can throw the football. He's proven it all day. Yeah, he had a couple of drops today, but right there, that was right on the money.
He's up to 350 yards passing. That was a 44-yarder. And that killer interception.
Hey, for the most part, he's been on the money all day.
Yes, he has. Just that one mistake. Just gave a look to the Vikings. That one deep into the end zone. There was good coverage. Penn wanted a call down there, but there was nothing to call.
Well, that was pretty much just thrown away.
Yeah.
Hey, Eric felt the pocket closing in on him. He saw that he didn't have what he wanted, and he just threw it out of the end zone.
Yeah, they were trying to run a double move on Hitchcock there. They wanted to run a slant and go. Hitchcock was already deep, holding off the end zone.
It'll be second and 10 at the 23-yard line of Minnesota. 2:03 remains. So the situation is an obvious one here. They need a quick score, they need the touchdown, and they got to get the ball right back. Has to go to the short man, that's Bones, and he's wrapped up immediately. Got maybe four on the play. That takes us to the 2-minute warning here in the fourth quarter. With the score, Minnesota 31, the Bears 21.
There's two downs left here. Do you go for the field goal on fourth down, or do you cap the play for a touchdown, come back with the onside kick, and play for the field goal afterwards? If it's me, I say you use the two downs and you play for the touchdown here.
Kramer, 4-5 on this drive. Has some time, going to the end zone. With a touchdown!
Well, no question on that. You don't have to get the fourth down.
Ryan Wetnight, that was not an easy catch. 19 yards for the score. A good pass, but a very good catch for the big tight end, Ryan Wetnight.
Well, it was a good catch, but really, Kramer put the ball where only it could have been caught. There was some pretty good coverage around Wetnight, but Kramer put the ball only where it could be caught. First of all, watch Wetnight work down the seam here.
And working down the seam, he works Rudd. He's able to get the ball over Rudd's head on that play.
And the point after is good. Kramer now 372 yards. That's the most ever for him. And it's 1:53 left. A three-point game. Bears had a successful onside kick earlier in this game.
Unknowingly, I think.
Yeah.
Watch him. He takes Rudd outside and comes back down on the inside. And the safeties, look, there's a lot of coverage around there, but he threw the ball only where it could be caught.
And Kramer, if you look at that, Kramer did an excellent job of looking at the safety, Orlando Thomas, and giving him a look going one way and then coming back to Wetnight on that play.
Recapping the Bears' scoring drive, 6 plays, 82 yards. 82 yards, Eric Kramer with Ryan Wetnight. Touchdown pass.
Ryan Wetnight comes up with a big catch, and Eric Kramer gets his team close. Vikings will bring their so-called hands team on here to try and avoid a fumble. Of course, they had their wide receiver Chris Walsh up there on that front line the first time as well, and the ball bounced right off his chest on a squib kick and turned into an onside victory for the Bears. This one a little more conventional onside lineup here.
Watch the backside.
Ball is loose, knocked out of bounds. Looked like it went off the hands of a Bear player. Let's wait and see.
Now, if that is touched, if it's touched by the Vikings, it's going to be where it's out of bounds.
There's some discussion about whether it was touched by a Bear or a or a Viking here. Looks like Chris Carter might have got a hand on it. We'll wait for the official word from Ed Hockley, and again another town meeting here to make sure that they get this one right, obviously with 1:52 left. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 striped shirts in this one. I thought a Bear player got a hand on it before it went anywhere else.
Well, it has to go 10 yards before a Bear can touch it.
Right, it looked to me like that occurred, but it also appeared to me that a Viking then touched it. Perhaps Carter.
The kickoff went out of bounds, which is a foul by the kicking team. However, the ball went beyond 20 yards, so by rule, it is not an onside kick. The receiving team accepts the result of the play, takes the ball at the out-of-bounds spot, first down.
All right, yep. Well, that's well explained.
Yeah. See, if it went out of bounds before it went 20 yards, they would re-kick that. But since it went 20 yards, it goes into where it goes out of bounds. You have to watch 10 yards. It's go past 10 yards, and there's
Penn. There's Penn getting a hand on it. Now the ball goes out of bounds, and of course it went out about, I'd say, 25, 27 downfield.
Well, he advances the ball right here and knocks it 20 yards.
So your point being that you still believe that that should have been an onside kick and they re-kick it?
That's what I believe, and that's what I'm looking at right there. They advanced the ball for 20 yards.
That the kick itself actually didn't go past the 20 yards to make it a regular kickoff, that it was advanced because of it hit the player. So you believe it should be re-kicked. Good point.
It is Viking ball at the 43-yard line, and 1:52 remains. So now the Bears defense has to make something happen.
And that's tough to do.
Yeah, it is, because they're just going to take off as much here as they can. 1:46. So that ball going beyond the 20 yards ruled not an onside kick, and so then the normal rules prevailing. The ball went out of bounds, and that is where the Vikings got the ball. Looks like there's still some discussion going on down there, but the clock is ticking down. 1:25. Randall Cunningham, 275 yards, 4 touchdowns today. Kramer, 372, 4 touchdowns. Absolutely brilliant performances by these two quarterbacks. A very untimely interception that kind of turned things around for the Vikings. After the Vikings got that pickoff from Fuller, they took the game away, they took the lead and rolled it up before the Bears battle back here with that pass to Wet Knight just moments ago.
I mean, the Bears, just look at the dejection by all of them. I mean, they're searching for answers.
And this clock is going to wind us down quickly enough here with the ability of the Vikings to do so on third down, that we will take you to the Giants in San Diego. You'll see the conclusion of that game. Our audience, we invite you to stay for some bonus coverage.
Well, right here, Tim, Bill, yeah, they're looking for answers, but they saw some good things. But when you go up against the three home run guys that you talked about at the beginning of the show, Bill, look what happens.
Wanstead out to congratulate Dennis Green, and the Vikings prevail 31-28. An exciting football game, but unfortunately for the Bears, the same result as they have had in the previous 3 weeks, leading at halftime and then losing in the second half. And their four losses have come by a total of 21 points.
Yeah, a little over 5 points a game.
Yeah.
That's a tough thing for them to swallow, especially with what you coupled with what you said, Timmy, and the fact that they led at halftime in all the games.
Yeah. Today it was 21-10, and then the Vikings scored after that Palmer kickoff return of 53 yards, set them up, and Cunningham hitting the tight end Glover to bring it to 21-17. And then after that, that interception by Fuller, that just turned it all in the Vikings' favor. So congratulations to the unbeaten Minnesota Vikings. And for Ronnie Lott and Bill Maas, this is Tim Ryan saying so long from Soldier Field. Let's take you to James Brown in Hollywood.
All right, Tim. Thanks.